Children, do you like going on a tour of the market? Let's go on a market tour with Appu and learn more about the three-digit numbers by grouping them. On the occasion of Appu's birthday, he has invited everyone to the party. To prepare for the party, he has come to buy some items from the market. Let us also walk with him. First, Appu visits Bunny Rabbit's stall. He has to buy hats for all the guests. I want 425 hats, Appu told Bunny. Bunny's business seems to be doing well. Look how crowded his stall is. Oh wow, see how fast Bunny is giving things to his customers. Appu immediately put forward his big bag. Bunny filled the hats in the bag at full speed. Appu did not get to know when Bunny filled his bag with hats. He gave money to Bunny for the hats and is returning home. Appu is counting the hats purchased from Bunny. What is this? Bunny gave Appu only 420 hats instead of 425 hats. Appu counted the hats twice but found the counts to be 420 hats only. Appu is disappointed. He was thinking that he should have counted the hats in the market itself. But with such a crowd at Bunny's shop, he was unable to count them at all. The next day, Appu goes to the market again. Let's see what he buys today. Appu had asked Barbola uncle to stitch his clothes for the birthday. He has to pick up his clothes from uncle's shop. Appu sees some shining bags at uncle's shop. Uncle, what are these bags for? Appu asked uncle. Appu, nowadays there is a lot of crowd at Bunny's stall. He works fast, due to which he often makes mistakes in counting. So I have stitched these bags for myself, uncle told Appu. But how will you use these bags? Appu asked uncle. Suppose you have to buy 367 balls from Bunny. I have two types of bags. One in which you can keep 100 items and the other in which you can keep 10 items. Let's first count these balls one by one. But doing this will take a lot of time. So why not count them in groups of 10 using the bags meant for 10 items? But this will still take quite a while. So why not collect all 10 bags and make a bag of 100 items? In this way, we can easily count 367 balls with the help of these bags for 10 items and 100 items. If we do this, we will have 3 bags of 100 items, 6 bags of 10 items and 7 balls. Did you see, Appu, how fast we counted these balls? Uncle said to Appu. Oh wow, uncle, give these bags to me too. They will be very useful for me. After taking the bags, Appu has reached Bunny's stall. Give me 224 masks. Children, can you write 224 in expanded form? Yes, you have written it correctly. Bring the bag forward, Bunny told Appu. This time, Appu first puts forward 2 bags of 100. He then puts forward 2 bags of 10. Give me my money, Bunny said to Appu. First of all, give me the 4 masks remaining. Then I will give you the money, Appu said to Bunny. Bunny was shocked at how Appu could count all the masks so quickly. He gave Appu his 4 masks and took the money from Appu. Appu went home happily after taking his bags and 4 masks. So children, today we learnt to count 3-digit numbers quickly by grouping. children, do you remember Appu's visit to the market? We learned to count three-digit numbers quickly by grouping in the last lesson. Children, we learned to write three-digit numbers in groups of 100, 10 and 1 with the help of Batak Uncle's bags. In the same way, we can write any three-digit number in the group of 100, 10 and 1. Let's look at another example of this. Suppose you have to count 281 eggs in the groups of 100, 10 and 1. So first, you write 281 in expanded form. Then by paying attention, you will find that 200 is made up of two groups of 100. 80 is made up of 8 groups of 10. And one egg does not come in any group. Let us now see how far Appu's birthday's preparations have reached and learn to identify three-digit numbers by grouping. To prepare for his birthday, Appu is going to Chanda's flower shop. Chanda sells large garlands of 100 flowers, small garlands of 10 flowers, and she also sells separate flowers. Chanda has given 3 garlands of 100 flowers, 2 garlands of 10 flowers, and separately 7 flowers to Appu to decorate his house. Appu is wondering how many flowers in total did Chanda give him. Let's see what this number is. If we add 3 garlands of 100 flowers each, then total is 300 flowers. Now we will add 2 garlands of 10 flowers. This total is 20 flowers. And we have 7 single flowers. Now we can identify the numbers with the help of the process of writing the numbers in expanded form. In this way, Chanda gave total of 327 flowers to Appu. Now Appu wants to take laddus for his guests. For every guest, he needs one laddu. He took 6 boxes of 100 laddus, 4 boxes of 10 laddus and 3 single laddus. Can you tell how many guests are coming to Appu's house? Let's do this together. There are 600 laddus in the 100 laddus box. There are 40 laddus in the 10 laddus box. And there are 3 single laddus. Now, we will write the expanded numbers and we get 643. Oh wow! 643 guests are coming to Appu's party. Let's join the party. Appu is celebrating his party in a grand way. So children, today we learned to identify 3-digit numbers by grouping. Hello children, did you enjoy Appu's party? In the previous video, we learned to identify 3-digit numbers by grouping. In this video, we will learn to write 3-digit numbers using tokens. Appu received lot of gifts in his party. Let's see what gifts he received. Bunny has gifted Appu 125 pencils. But because Bunny makes a mistake while counting fast, Appu is counting them again. Appu is counting pencils in a unique way. Every pencil Appu counts, he places a token with the number 1 on the table. When he has such 10 tokens, he changes them with a token that has 10 written on it. Now, when he has such 10 tokens, he replaces them with a token with 100 written on it. In this way, Appu counted all 125 pencils and showed them with 1 token of 100, 2 token of 10 and 5 token of 1. Appu counted 125 pencils using his tokens. We can easily identify and write 3-digit numbers using such tokens. Using this method, we can write any 3-digit number using Appu's token of 100, 10 and 1. Badbola Batak uncle has given 407 toffees to Appu. Can you write the number of these toffees in the token of 100, 10 and 1? Let's write it together. We can write 407 in this way in the expanded form. We can write 400 as 4 tokens of 100. There are no 2-digit numbers here, so we will not use any token of 10. We will write 0 in the place of the token of 10 and 7 will be shown using 7 tokens of 1 in this manner. In this way, we can write 407 toffees in tokens of 100, 10 and 1. Now Appu is counting the marbles given by Sher Khan using tokens. He used 7 tokens of 100, 6 tokens of 10 and 0 token of 1. Can you write the number of marbles given by Sher Khan with these tokens? Let us understand the process. We can write 7 tokens of 100 for the number 700, then 6 tokens of 10 for 60, and finally there are no tokens for 1. So, we will write 0 in the token of 1. Now we can easily identify 3-digit numbers in this expanded form. Oh wow! Sher Khan gifted Appu 760 marbles. Come on children, complete this table with the process we have learnt. Well done children, you have given the correct answers. Appu is so happy to see so many gifts. So children, in this lesson, we learnt to write 3-digit numbers using tokens.